Okay. Should be good now. Longer setup than usual. It looked like the game was lagging when I was viewing the streams. I can't move. Oh no. Okay, we're good. But it only happened whenever I closed the capture window. I don't know. It was kind of weird. Anyway, we're good. So, last time we got confused by a pencil, and I believe we solved that mystery. We should have something called, like, the pencil eraser. Yeah, absolutely do. Okay. We got some kind of weird broken machine as well, but it's... I used it and it disappeared, so I might be crap out of luck on that one. I probably will not... I mean, I shouldn't say probably, because I have no idea, but I'm not sure how to get that back. I'm pretty sure I know what to do next. Let's go ahead and check our status. We look pretty good. So we need to go back to the valley and assumingly use the pencil eraser on the pencil. I'm trying to, if you're wondering what I'm stuttering around about, I'm trying to decide if I want to store anything. Like, I guess you could say I probably don't need the town map. The roller, I'm probably pretty safe to deposit because I don't know what it does. Protein drink, I also don't know what it does. Recover about 80 HP. Okay, so I don't want to put that in. Okay, I guess we can store the... You know, yeah, you know what? We'll do it because I don't know what items I'll get up ahead. I wasn't going to spend the money to store the roller, but, you know. We'll just go ahead and do it. Pick up. Okay, and we'll meet the guy outside. I believe we're at full health. The status window says we're pretty high up anyway, so I'm just going to presume we're full health. Hello. Wow, I thought it was like 10. Okay, that's, whatever, it's fine. Roller, store. I really hope I don't need that. Alright, anyway. Wait, what? Did I not... He didn't take it. I thought I skipped it. Okay, I did skip. At least he didn't charge me. Okay, that's my fault for being stupid. And trying to skip through text quickly. Alright, call him back again. What a good start to the episode. Okay, Scargo Express. And skip through this, pick up. Okay, cool. Now we won't screw it up this time. There he is, he took longer to show up. Yes. Just the roller. There it is. No. Yes. Okay, now we're set. We have two free inventory spaces. It's not a lot, but it's all we can really work with. Give me one second here. The having difficulties. Where is that? Game might have froze, just give me a second here. I mean, it didn't freeze, but I had the window closed at the second. Okay. I'm just making sure everything's capturing. Okay, like I said, there were a little bit of problems when we first started, but from the looks of it, everything's okay. Okay. I don't know, I'm being paranoid over nothing. Also, where is Valley? Down below. I think the only healing item we have is the... I mean, we have a hamburger... Oh, no, okay, we have a protein drink, a hamburger, and a ketchup packet, which I still haven't used yet, so I'm not sure what it does. Evidently, it applies condiments to the hamburger automatically and improves it, I guess. I don't know, we haven't had a chance to use it. I am really... I mean, words can't describe how... much I want this to be the correct answer. I mean, if it's not the pencil eraser, I really don't know what to do, but I mean, it almost has to be. That would make sense, right? uh, I'm just trying to think. Like I said, I would go to the hint guy, but he's fucking so expensive. Yeah, I got nothing else. I don't know. If the pencil eraser doesn't work, it's going to be a bunch of random guessing until we get it. I guess if it doesn't work, we'll just have to head down to the direction of... What's the name of that town? Threed, I think? And hope things pan out. There's Mushroom Girl. Also, yeah, I came up with that idea that maybe I get a mushroom on my head and talk to her, but like I said, that's a bit of a stretch. But I'm thinking this will work. Trying to avoid UFOs, but I don't see any. I don't know why I'm trying to avoid them. There's probably a boss somewhere around here, so I probably shouldn't be stupid enemies. I'm just gonna fight it. I don't have a lot of PP, so if I catch a cold, then you know I'm gonna have to heal it. Okay, off to a terrible start. Yep. I'm pretty sure buying the yo-yo was a horrible idea as well, because it seems like it's missing. Or was it the slingshot? Either or, but it's missing a shit ton. Fuck. Please don't die here. Okay. Now the moment of truth. Please, for the love of God, work. Ness used the pencil eraser. For some reason, the iron pen... Oh, thank God. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. That's an hour and some odd minutes of our life gone, but we figured it out. What's up here? Hello? Sounds like Fuzzy Pickle music. It is Fuzzy Pickles. Sweet. Very, very random. Okay, cool. Oddly enough, there's nothing up here. No, but there's a butterfly there. How's my health? I don't think I can get past the UFO before I get to the butterfly. Hopefully it doesn't despawn. From what I remember, too, cold remedies are pretty expensive in the store, aren't they? They were like 38. I think they were 38 bucks. As much as, like, I pretty much hitch. Oh, what the fuck? Is that an enemy? Yeah, it is. I think it is. It's moving. Alright. What am I doing? I am off my game today. Healing. There we go. I guess you're an enemy? You're kind of. Yeah, okay, you are an enemy. Territorial Oak. This is the first encounter we've had with you. Let's see how hard you hit. Brain Shock. What's that do? Did not work. Okay, so I don't know what it does. Did not work. Interesting. Ooh, okay, they hit hard. A vacuum at- oh shit! Okay, I don't like these enemies. He lowered my offense by 2 and my defense by 1. Burst into flames. What? That say 200 and- did I misread that? I think it said 206. That would have killed me if that wasn't the final attack. Maybe it just- I don't know. That was kind of weird. Like, I know rolling damage is a thing in this game, so I probably stopped taking damage as soon as the battle ended, but if that wasn't the last turn, that would have killed me. Okay. Let's be cautious of trees in the future. I am not going to avoid them because I kind of want to figure out how the battles... Ooh, that's different. Health is not... Okay, we should be okay. This is a new... yes, it is new. Spinning Robo. Fired a beam, 20... Okay, not too bad, not too bad. Not as bad as the trees. 52. Okay, they seem to have some health. Okay, that... Not a bad enemy. prefer it over the UFO, because this one didn't give me nighttime stuffiness. Also, there is a present up there, so I'm gonna have to figure out how to get up there. Also, now I said about the butterfly despawning, it seems it did. Oh, no! Little bastard, get here. What's up, old Rusty? How you doing? Old Rusty, no D. My bad. So, if we can... I need to figure out how to... Oh, there's another butterfly. That's convenient. I think I'm full health. Yeah, I am. Let's go ahead and grab this, too. So, I need to remember, right across this bridge, I can probably force spawn butterflies if I need... I don't know how big this area is. It looks like this goes... Okay, it looks like I get up there from the other side. I drop 15 frames. Forever shall be missed. Okay. Can I go south? No, I have to go this way. Okay, I definitely don't want to pull all three enemies. Especially with a damn UFO. See, I still haven't figured out how to do force despawning. Okay, so there I despawned the one, but I'm not sure how I did it. Okay, and there I spawned the butterfly. This is fucking confusing. I don't understand this. Yeah, okay, whatever. Yellow. First time playthrough? Yeah. I hesitated there because I had played through the previous section a couple times. I just never made it this far yet. I don't like this. Too many enemies. I'm being very pussyfooted, I know, but I really don't want to go back and start this area again. Okay, I'm going to take this. I can deal with this. Now, I do have Psy Slime, which I don't think I've ever used, but it uses so much PP. But that's okay, because there's a butterfly up ahead, so we're going to give it a try. No, that's not true. I did use it. I used it during the first boss battle to get rid of the extra ants. Okay. No nighttime stuffiness. Fuck. Whatever weapon I have blows. I should have kept the bat, because I'm missing so often. Yeah, I'm enjoying the game so far. It's, I'm not gonna lie, I got a little muffed about the whole pencil thing. I was stuck on it for a while. But, finally... figured it out, I guess, by guessing. Yeah, not too bad so far. The only problems I really had is the pencil and that fucking tree. I don't know what's up with the tree. It kind of just blew up and... I'm lucky it was the last turn, put it that way. Yeah, I think that's what I do have is a slingshot. I replaced my bat. And I'm noticing that I'm missing, like, half my hits. Oddly enough, I actually hit every time on that one. And those fucking robots do give you nighttime stuffiness, which I believe acts like poison. Travel charm. Okay, let's see what that does. Must be equipment printer proud. Oh wait, don't I already have a travel charm? Oh yeah, I already have one. Okay. Well, that's shop fodder. What am I doing? I can't menu today at all. Okay. There was a butterfly, but I don't really need it yet. Now, I don't think that top UFO can get to me because of the ledge. Yeah, okay, I'm good. So this should be a spinning robo, right? Yep. And he starts off the battle by being an asshole. Luckily, it looks like, I don't get four... Oh, shit. I probably should have healed. Okay, I'll heal now. It looks like you only take four damage from nighttime stuffiness. It doesn't seem to scale with level, which is kind of cool. Oh, God, that was close. Okay. Let's not take us down to one HP ever again. Slingshots have a higher chance of missing. Yeah, I kind of figured. I'm gonna... Ooh, offense by 6. I will take it. Okay, very good level up. HP by 20. Okay, that excellent level up. Got a pretty decent stat increase on every single one. Healing. Okay, let's see. Okay, a butterfly did spawn again in that area. Tree. I said I wouldn't avoid it, but I'm going to avoid it for... Does it chase you? Oh, it does. Abort. Oh, God. Abort, abort. Probably definitely don't want to trigger two of them. Oh, fuck. I'm in a pickle now. I still haven't figured out the mechanics of this particular enemy. From what I gathered, when it bursts into flames, that's going to be a bad time. And that's kind of shitty, too. Okay, can you not? Eh, I mean, I might be able to mitigate. I'm worried about it blowing up. I don't know if it blows up at random or it just blows up whenever you kill it. Okay. I mean, as long if it blows up when you kill it, as long as I have enough health to survive till the end of the battle, should be okay. The rolling damage should save me. Fuck. Okay, I should probably heal. Man, they hit like tank. Well, that he lowered my defense quite a bit too. Don't know what brain shot does. It misses every time. Yeah, it doesn't work. Okay, is he gonna burst into flames? Yes. And he did over 200 damage. Okay, so he burst... Okay, it's not that bad, I guess. It bursts into flame whenever you kill it. As long as you have enough damage... What am I trying to say? As long as you have enough health left to have rolling damage make you survive till the... I don't know what the fuck... I know what I'm trying to say. I don't know how to articulate it. Like, with rolling damage... You have a chance to heal, even if you get, like, if you have 150 health and it deals 200 damage, you can still technically survive with rolling, the rolling damage decrease, if you can heal in time or end the battle. Yeah. Basically, that's how I survived the last two battles with those trees. It's really, it's not a complicated thing, it's just I can't articulate it correctly. Okay, so, oh, there's a present. There is a luck capsule. Okay. I could probably guess what this does. It increases your luck when taken. Permanently, or is this like a battle item? Well, if it lets me use outside of battle, then I would assume it's permanently. Yeah, okay, that's fine. So, permanent stat increase from the looks of it. Hell's health. Kinda shite, to be honest. I still have a decent amount of psi, so... Go ahead and heal like this. I wanna... Trees are kind of assholes, so I think I am gonna try to avoid them when possible. Yeah, he despawned. And I'm pretty sure I have to go this way. Oh god, he almost got to jump on me. Alright, let's skip nighttime stuffiness. Oh, nope, can't do that. Alright, we're gonna stick with nighttime stuffiness for a while. Oh! My screen flashed red. 144. I want to test something here. 140. Oh, you take damage outside of battle too with it. I did not know that. Alright. Abort that idea. Let's get rid of that right now. Okay, here's our friend with the bridge. I wonder who made the bridge impassable. Why would someone do this? Crud! I don't know. Can I have the bridge back, though? Because it seems to be a shortcut. There's a present over here, which I can't hold. Croissant. Oh, I can't hold it. That's right, I did use the luck cap, so I believe these heal 60? Yeah, okay. That's good. I probably should be grinding a little bit. I want to explore this area. There's a bomb inside. Oh, I thought it was a trap. I guess I can take said bomb? Unfortunately, inventory space is not a luxury we have right now. Surprisingly enough, I still have the pencil eraser. Thought it might have got used up. Well, I mean, a last ketchup packet. We never got to use you, but I think I'll take the bomb over the ketchup packet. Okay, let's see what it does. I imagine it's an item to damage enemies. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. It may affect others besides the target. Okay, so I'm guessing it can probably hurt your party members too. We're gonna save. Oh shit! Tree. Yeah, I'm not really sure what ketchup packets. I mean, I read the tutorial from the guy said that condiments are applied automatically, so I imagine it increases the health recovered whenever you eat a hamburger, but inventory spaces aren't, like I said, a luxury we have right now till we get our second party member, I guess, so I'm gonna have to pick and choose which items I want to have right now. I think I'm going backwards. I got mixed up at some point. I'm trying to figure out if I'm going the right way or not. I don't know. I got a little distracted by the bomb. Man, I can't hit these fucking UFOs for worth shit. It's actually triggering me a little bit here. Thank you. Keep using nighttime stuffiness. I hope the next town I can get a different weapon. Ideally another baseball bat, because they seem to have pretty good accuracy. Well, definitely not going the right way, because that's a dead end. Okay, I don't have a map either, so we're gonna have to just do this systematically here. I think this is the right way, if it's not a dead end. Okay, yeah, this is different. Yeah, okay, this is definitely different. I could really use a butterfly, too. Oh, that's fine. We'll take this guy down. I have enough to do two more nighttime stuffiness heals. After that, I'm kind of fucked. Yep. And I also don't know if there's a boss battle in this area. If it is, I'm probably going to die, honestly. Since I'm going to be out of PP. So I have one, two, three healing items, a damaging items, and damaging items. Good grammar. Travel charm. You know what I should have brought? I should have brought the for sale sign. I forgot I stored it. You know what? We already have nighttime stuffiness. We'll get the XP off this guy. Yeah, look at that accuracy. That's just pretty amazing. I should probably heal to be safe. I forget how much hamburger is. I think it's 80, isn't it? Oh, nope, 54. That's a weird number. To be fair, though, when you read the item description, it does say about 60 HP. It doesn't say 60 HP for sure. So I guess there's a little bit of RNG mixed in there. And we're still low on health. Okay, I have enough for one more cold. Oh, thank you. Exactly what I needed. So this looks like progress, so I probably need to backtrack and go down to the south to make sure we didn't miss anything. Yeah, we got enough PP to heal up. Okay. I believe that butterfly was our Hail Mary pass for this area too, because we probably would have died up ahead. Ah! Man, did you see that? He spun it. Wow, we got the jump on him. I thought he was going to try to go around me and get me from behind. That was very bad wording on my part. I apologize. Alright, good. That was easy. So if the butterfly was there, I wonder if I can force spawn another one, because that's been working okay in my favor so far. I'm going to force spawn an enemy again. Yeah, look at that. Cool. I like this. It's kind of cheap, I know, but whatever. It's a mechanic in the game, so why not use it? Also, we need to figure out a way to get up that tree! You sneaky bastard. Okay, we got around it. I need to figure out a way to get up there. Yep, definitely need to figure it out because there's a present there. I don't know if this is... No, this is a dead end. Okay, let's be on the other side. Tree despawned. Butterfly? No, you're up there. Oh, here we go. That worked out. I bet I just despawned it, though. Also, random house. Yeah, I despawned it. Okay. A lot of ways to go here. Let's check this way out. Because I know this probably is in progress, because it seems to be... I don't know where this is going. To a present. Excellent. Hard hat. That sounds like an item upgrade. Yeah, pretty hefty one. Plus 9 defense. I'll take it. I'll take it. Now, if you give me a weapon, too, I'd be really appreciative. Because I really need to get rid of this yo-yo, like ASAP. There might be a butterfly here. Nope, 2 UFOs, though. So. Oh, shit. Oh, boy. Tyson's in a pickle. Yeah, I fucked up. I really fucked up that. Miss. Okay, I'll take that. That wasn't too bad of an opening attack. I was expecting a lot of damage. Oh wow, that hard hat. Thank you. You only did 6 damage. Yeah, I'll take it. I'll take it for sure. Yeah, the whole force spawning and despawning of enemies can either be a saving grace or a fucking fuck you over moment. 17, 1. Okay, not the best level up. We did get 4 PP though. Hello? Why are the enemies still there? Did I just freeze? Yeah, okay, I froze them. What am I doing? Still can't. No! Healing, thank you. Okay, there's so many paths here. I don't know what I've explored. Okay, that's backtracking, so. God damn it! Fuck it. There's no way to get around it. I'm gonna have to kill one of them. Just gotta be careful here. Still have no idea what brain shock does, because it never works. Well, like, I like the whole being able to, like... Hold on one sec. Oh, shit. Okay, see, yeah, it did 350 damage because of the rolling damage. I didn't die. That's what I was trying to explain earlier, but didn't do very well at. But yeah, the whole spawning, like, being able to force spawn and despawn things are, like I said, it can either be a saving grace or it can completely fuck you over. Luckily, I did spawn a couple butterflies, so I'm okay on PP. I don't know if this is progress, but we're gonna check this out. No, that's a dead end. Okay. Hello, butterfly. Speaking of force spawning, I'll take you. Okay, so I believe we explored everything, but excuse me, I almost sneezed there. I believe we explored everything, and this is the only path left. I don't have nighttime stuffiness at the moment. You know what? Screw it. I need the XP anyways, because it's been quite a while since we fought a boss, so there has to be one coming up pretty soon. And I don't want to be skipping all these enemies and get screwed over and have to come back and spend 20-30 minutes grinding. Plus the hard hat's really saving us whenever it comes to damage. They're not really doing a whole lot of damage right now. They're just more annoying than anything. From the looks of it, it looks like there's a town up ahead. I believe it's, the guys say it's like happy town or something. But I don't know if this is just like random houses in the valley or that's the actual town. 520 XP, not bad. How much do we have to level up? 2,000, okay. It's fine. There was a present we missed somewhere, and I believe it's this way. Do we have inventory space? We do not, but I guess I could get rid of the croissant. Probably should have not healed with Psy there. Cup of life noodles. Okay, that sounds like I should probably take that, just considering it has the word life in it. Maybe it's like an auto-revive, or you can revive a party member. What do I want to get rid of? I mean, I have two travel charms, but I kind of want to sell it. Fortunately, I don't know how much it sells for, so I'm just going to have to use the croissant. Where'd it go? Let's not accidentally use it. Cup of life noodles. Okay, yep. It's a revive. Oh, wait. Ah, I skipped all that. I need to read. Wow, that was a lot of fucking okay, let's read that. Revives a friend who's unconscious. Well, we have a stroke here. In addition, it also works well on poison, nausea, cold, sunstroke, falling asleep, uncontrollable crying, and feeling strange. Okay. This is effective when you have paralysis or have been diamondized. So it revives and it heals. Oh, stat! Oh my god, I didn't see that tree. Luckily, I didn't. Somehow did not end up triggering a battle with it. $133. Oh boy, I don't think I can despawn these. I'm not going to be able to get far enough away. We might be fighting through a gauntlet here. Yeah, I missed them all. Every single one of those enemies, I didn't miss them. And excuse me, I didn't see them. Yeah, I'm going to have to fight my way through this. I can't get far enough away to despawn them. Oh boy, I really don't want to use... I don't know if any of these work at all on these guys. I doubt it. Shield can probably mitigate some of my damage, but let's get rid of, you know what? Let's just hope we don't miss a bunch with our slingshot. Did it heal itself? I think it did. I skipped through that text too fast. Oh, maybe not. Vacuum attack's fine. I just need to make sure I have enough HP to survive the final attack. Yeah, keep doing what you're doing. It's fine. Yeah, that's fine too. I'm not taking as much damage now since I have the hard hat. I don't know what a safe number is, but so far I've been staying above 90 for the final hit. This should be it though. Yeah, burst into flames. 240 damage. Okay, yeah, I'm fine. We're okay. Let's heal up to be safe because I don't know what's up ahead. Shit. I'm in a pickle. I might be able to despawn those ones. Well, I spawned another. Oh wow, that backfired, didn't it? Yeah, that backfired. I'm kind of like screwed right now. I think I'm just gonna have to bite the bullet and fight them all. Somehow avoided nighttime stuffiness. It's not jinx. Come on, slingshot. Alright, whatever. It works. If I want to try to avoid the tree if possible. Maybe I can do it if I can get pull this thing down. Come on. Well, it wasn't graceful, but it did work. So I'm hoping I can outrun the tree now. Yeah, I know. I'm pretty well leveled for this area. I'm just being cautious because I don't know how much of it's left. Tree. Uh-oh. Tree, can you fuck off for a minute? I think I've explored up north. There's a cave here, so. Yeah, I think this area is pretty well. Can you not? I think this area is pretty well explored. Yeah, I don't think I'm getting past this tree, so let's just do it. Okay, two hits so far. Oh, good battle. Works for me. Man, he still does so much damage, though. I mean, I guess the only way to really die from that attack is if you weren't paying attention to your health at the end, but... I mean, I can see dying to it the first time you fought it, but not any other times after that, unless you have no way of healing, of course. So I guess this is it. Are those low-level snakes? Yes they are. Give me my 1 XP. Such a random placement for that. Where are we at now? Happy, happy village. Okay, so it is a town. I am not your enemy, I'm just a plain old mole. You are certainly stronger than when you are wandering around Onet. Have you ever suddenly gotten a message you won mess- What? Okay, I read that wrong, obviously. I know what it's talking about, though. Okay. Don't care. I have a town map. I do not. Hello, butterfly. Excuse me, Taurus. I'm collecting donations to help protect the world from contaminants. Donate whatever you can. I'll get the postcard later. Well, there's a red house. I was gonna say, all these houses are teal. Wish I had a town map. Alright, well, we'll just go through it one by one then. One day, Mr. Carpenter... Oh, wait, Car Painter... Oh, excuse me, received a revelation. He now speaks the real truth. Sounds kind of creepy. Wow, this town is really blue. We wanted to join the Happy Happy Religious Group. We're a married couple from Tucson. Our child is waiting for us in Tucson. As a souvenir, we'd like to bring him some happiness. Getting weird vibes. You must understand what I have to say, but Car Painter... I'm going to keep trying to say Carpenter, I know, but... Car Painter's voice affects one's mind like a hypnotist. Good pronunciation. Pronunciation, very good. Hypnotist. Sound it out. Hypnotist. There we go. Thank you, English. You don't seem to understand, so I'll explain it to you. When the world is changed to blue, a peaceful country can be established. Do you understand now? I can tell by your face that you're only pretending to understand. You just want something. Yeah, I'm definitely getting culty vibes here. This is the famous Happy Happyism Counseling Office. When you obtain happiness, you should visit the Happy Happyism Headquarters. It's located in the center of the village. Yeah, a little bit weird. I heard many footsteps exist down deep in the East Cave. People call that place Lilliput Steps and makes them feel uneasy. Could that be our next sanctuary location? I'm monitoring those who don't pay at the food stand. I also need a drink because I feel like I'm almost choking on my own tongue. What food stand, by the way? This thing? We trust you. Feel free to shop here. What would you like to buy? Banana or egg? Neither. Excellent. What are you doing, creepy? I think that those who won't paint everything blue are... this is definitely a cult. I want them to listen, even if it requires kicking their butts. This is like a metaphor for fucking Scientology, isn't it? Sorry. Please don't sue. I can't stop thinking... There's a place up ahead that can't be painted blue. It's strange and anti-blue place. I can't stop thinking about it, and I can't go near that place. Well, we have two caves here. Alright, let's explore the town more, then we'll check these caves out. All of our products are blessed. Blue drugstore. Oh, a drugstore. Excellent. We should have a decent amount of money now. The information on the back of the refreshing herb reads as follows. If you catch a cold, if you're ill, or if you can't seem to heal, if you're poisoned, if you're depressed, a refreshing herb is the real deal. I know, it seems pretty iffy, but you should give it a try. So herbs heal lots of status effects. They are 80 bucks though. Also, we have cold remedies, which are 22 and not 32, so that's okay. Croissant, skip, lucky sandwich, still don't know what that does. We also now have access to a cup of coffee, which I don't know what it does. I assume it has something to do with PP. Let's see what our weapons are. Hello, Sandlot Bad, I've been waiting for you. Copper bracelet. They are now selling items for party members we don't have, so that's a good sign. Because an additional party member means more inventory space, which I desperately need. So I need about, let's see here, a lot. about a little over 450, I guess. Okay, yeah, we got plenty of money, so it's fine. Let's take 500 out, that's enough. And I didn't count the money we're gonna get from selling stuff. I have a couple things to sell. Okay, so get rid of this travel charm. Sure, 30 bucks. Thank you. The Sandlot Bat. Yes. 44 to 40. Okay, not a huge improvement, but I believe the accuracy will be worth it alone. Yes, get rid of this goddamn slingshot. And we need the... what is it? Copper bracelet? Really expensive. I hope it's worth it. 30 to 30. Okay, that's not bad. Yes. I want to sell. I believe there's one more thing I wanted to sell. Maybe not. Oh, yeah, Mr. Baseball Cap. Okay. Oh, 100 bucks for that. Okay, good. I mean, we haven't been having trouble with battle, so I see no reason to deposit our money. 372 to the next level. Okay, good. Alright, so we are pretty set on items right now. Let me just take a look at stuff. I mean, the only thing we've had pretty much since the beginning is the travel charm now, which is... prevents paralysis, but I don't think I have much of a problem with that. I mean, we'll replace it whenever we get something new. Are you an enemy? Yes, you are. Barely caught that. Insane. Oh, okay. Cultus. Yep. Cult confirmed. Okay, we talked to them. I believe we've done everything here. Excuse me, Tori, I'm supposed to be known as to print the word for damage. I already donated to you. Is she following? She is following me. Yo, really? There's a butterfly here. You can have it, because I don't need it. Well, the thing is, like, there's definitely a difference between the slingshot and the previous bat I had. Because that slingshot, especially on the UFOs, I was missing 3 out of 4 times. And I didn't even come close to that whenever I had the baseball bat. So, yeah, there's a huge difference in accuracy. Also, how do I make this bitch fuck off? Do I have to... okay, so evidently she doesn't fuck off unless you give her money. Definitely a metaphor for Scientology. Sorry, don't sue. Blue, blue, I wish for everything in this world to become blue. Oh, you didn't play any music this time. Come on, then. You better help in battles, at least. Let's find out. I kinda highly doubt she does. It'd be kinda cool, though. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, she doesn't help out. She's just a cultist following us until we give her a dollar. Okay, can you not? I mean, I guess it's fine. These guys are easy and they probably have decent XP, so yeah, keep calling. That's fine with me. I mean, I also don't want to get too overleveled because I do like a good challenge in my games, and so far I haven't really had... Have I died? I can't remember. I honestly can't remember if I died. I think I might have during the Frank battle, but I'm not sure. I can't remember. Psy Flash, huh? Okay, let's see what it does. I believe we do it like this. Oh, it's offense. Okay. It generates a strong flash and can make the enemy start crying uncontrollably, and in some circumstances feel strange. That was very vague. Also, blue cow. A blue cow? Or a blue moo? Mr. Carpainter communicates with the divine, so he is able to deliver inspiring messages. I'm not sure doing. What the fuck? Friends? In valley behind the reed. Ding, ding. Alright then. Alright, time for you to go away. Oh yeah, the postcard. I forgot about it. Does it do anything? We'll check that house out in a minute. Like I said, everybody, I've said this every episode, I am taking my time in this game and exploring everything, so we're gonna have slow moments here and there. Also, I was kind of not paying attention to that, and I just saw Paula's name, so I'm gonna read this again. I won't tell you fuck! Come on. Repeat yourself. God damn it. Try using, I assume you're talking about the postcard. You feel sad and empty. Oh, thanks for that. So pretty much it's the opposite of what the chick does? I don't know. Because if I'm remembering correctly, the chick makes you happy. It doesn't seem... I guess it's not a big deal because it isn't... Ugh! Let's try that again. It doesn't seem like it gives you any kind of negative status. Make an exception, let you stay here for $50. No, I don't really... I guess this is like the hotel for the place here. I don't really need to heal right now, though. Okay, so bottom left corner, it with next to the blue moo is the hotel. Meet your living farm. Lodgings available. Okay, are you going to repeat yourself? I saw something about. Here we go. Psst, 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 psst. That overweight kid helped me. We kidnapped Paula. You know she's hidden in a mountain cabin. Oh, now I've done it. I thought you were one of us. You know I was joking. Ha ha ha! Just forget it. Okay, that's definitely hit music as well. So, Paula in a mountain cabin. Okay. Also, I think I skipped some buildings in the middle of town. So, let's go back up. Have we talked to you? When I painted everything blue, as Mr. Carpainter said, my wife had run out of me, returned home. Run out on me, returned home. I don't think we've been in here yet. You want to talk to Mr. Carpainter directly. You must think you're pretty important, and boy, do we have a lot of nerve. You deserve to be struck by lightning. Okay. Ah! Abort! Are these enemies? Jesus. You know what? I'll come back here. That looks like that's kind of plot-related, so we'll go back. I already talked to you. I think we've pretty much explored the town, except for maybe this house, and maybe if there's one down in the right-hand corner. No, but there is a ginger. Let's talk to it. Mr. Carpainter wants a girl. No, I don't want it like that. I mean, he's looking for a girl who could be the High Priestess of Happy-Happyism. I heard he's already got her. Yeah, I'm gonna go back to that house. Though you may not believe it, okay, you're the healer. Okay, good. No, I don't need anything, though. So, there's no hospital here. Okay, this should be the last house. Let me check out the caves. Here's Doctor. Blue, I'm not busy right now. Shall I explain the hospital? No. Okay. Even the doctors are tainted by the cult. I have options now. I can check out this... I guess it's a chapel or a church. Or I could do the caves. Let's do the cave. Place of can't be strange and anti. I imagine that's probably the place we want to go, so let's check out this one first. This might be transitioning to a new area. This might have not been the best idea. Yeah, it looks like it goes back into the valley. Or not, it's just a dead end. Okay, so it's this house. Are you Paula? Who? Are you Ness? Ness, I'm glad it's you. I had a dream of... Oh, this is... Wow, that was lucky. I had a dream that was a boy named Ness was my destiny. I thought to get Paula, would have to go into church. I know it's hard to believe. Therefore, I knew you would rescue me. If you didn't come, I would have tried to bust out up here. You can't open the door. You'll have to get the key from Carpainter. He's got it hidden away. I heard Carpainter can control lightning. In that case, you should wear the Franklin badge, okay? What should give us? The Franklin badge? Franklin badge, by keeping it as one of your items, you deflect lightning attack back at the attacker. That seems pretty important. We should probably put that on. Hello? Wait, did I... Why can't I equip it? Maybe you don't... Maybe you use it in battle? I don't know. Oh, what the fuck? Are you Pokey? Hey, Ness, you're just going to bother me, aren't you? You can call me Master... Oh, it is Pokey. You can call me Master Pokey, since Mr. Carpainter made me an important person in Happy Happyism. You should join us, but I know you won't. I'm glad I joined. Oh, you are still a cunt. I'm not going to fight you, but these guys will. Later, Potato. Yeah, he's still a little prick. Is that a spike? What the fuck? What's up with the low-level enemies? Does this do damage? We're gonna find out right now. No, but we did make a crow cry, so I guess it's not a total loss. I don't know what crying does. Okay, now I'm confused. I wasn't expecting to find Paula there. Crying lowers accuracy, okay. But anyway, I wasn't expecting to find Paula there, so it kind of messed up my plan of attack. I guess I'll check out the second cave and then go to the church or whatever it is. I assume the church is where I need to go next, so I'm going to check out the second cave. Problem is, though, I believe that guy alluded to the fact that this might be our next sanctuary location, so maybe I can't do this yet? Oh yeah, I'm not liking this. Oh shit, there's enemies here. Please, please don't destroy me. Mole Plane Rough. Okay, it's kind of adorable. Also, where's its red nose? Okay, they don't hit hard. Maybe this is what I'm supposed to do. Wow, tons of XP too. I mean, this looks like a pretty involved area. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna go back and check out the church. Also, let's note the red nose on the mole that just happens to disappear whenever you go in the battle. Yep, just gone. Oh, that did some pretty hefty damage there. 36. Yeah, we'll come back to this in a minute. I probably should have explored this church a little bit more. Maybe there's nothing even to do. I did see a present in there. I completely neglected, though, so... Can you, like, get out of the way? Thanks. Let's heal up to be sure. Also, I'm kind of... Let's see if we can find a butterfly over here. About half my PP's gone. I believe there's a butterfly in this penned area. Oh, for the love of God, fuck off. No, you're not getting anything else. You're annoying, but I'm not going to donate out of principle at this point. I mean, like, I generally don't mind tips as long as it doesn't spoil the story or in specific what I'm supposed to do. I mean, if it's kind of vague or it's not going to, like, spoil anything, I don't mind. Just don't do blatant spoilers. Because, like I said, I haven't played this game before up to this point, so I would like to go through it blind. Let's see. Wow, there is no butterfly. Okay, I'm gonna have to heal up at the healer. You know what? Screw it. Let's see if there's even anything to fight in here. I mean, from the looks of it, it's just a bunch of cultists. Hello? Maybe I can't even do anything here right now. Blue, Blue, you'd like to be one of us, then give up what you're doing and go meet Mr. Carpenter as soon as possible. Well, that one just moved. Croissant, do I have anything to get rid of? Put your postcard. Oh, I guess I don't really need that. So I can get another one at any point. Nope. What the hell? So it looks like you just talk to the ones that are kind of in your way, I guess. Oh, that one wants to fly. Okay, I'm a little bit confused about this area. I mean, yeah, it's not a big deal. As long as it doesn't spoil anything story-related, I really don't care. I think I'm pretty much going in the right direction now, I hope. But you wanting to say something makes me think maybe I'm not. But yeah, if it's going to spoil anything, just hold off for a bit. If I get super stuck, I will ask for help. Okay, I'm not really sure why I ended up fighting that one. And these ones aren't fucking off, so... They have... I mean, I'm not noticing... I guess... Maybe get rid of this. Okay, yeah, that one moved. So yeah, maybe you just guess. I'm not really sure here. So I tried to talk to the one on the right, and auto-targeted the one on the top, so maybe I'm just gonna spam L. No, okay. Yeah, even when I try to talk to the one on the left, it still targets the right. So I just have to generally be close. Also, I want that present up there. All right. You know what, I can't use Psy because I'm low on PP already. Okay. 1,000! Holy shit. Okay, awesome. Unfortunately, killing him didn't open up a new path. Wow, this is just ridiculous. I believe I already talked to these guys. I'm trying to find, like, some of them are turned in different directions than the other. Maybe those ones move? No, but they do talk. Okay, so he moved. Are you gonna move too? Green, green. Oops, that's not it. I'm still new at this. Okay, that was pretty awesome. Well, that worked out. Skip sandwich. You can stay there. I don't really need a skip sandwich right now. Blue, I'm trying to learn how to whistle. I heard that whistling makes you want to smile. I'll practice over there. Okay, thank you. And then you should move, right? You're a strange unmasked fellow. Don't go to... What? Blue, you strange unmasked fellow. Don't go to heaven. Don't go to heaven. I pretty much think he just told me to go to hell then. Awesome. Very subtle, Nintendo. Okay, it looks like we got into the clearing finally. Okay, let's see. Oh boy, this place is a little bit more laggy than what we're used to. Look at those frame rates. Look at that. Can I do anything with you? Blue, why would a person who's not blue be here? I mean, let's be honest here, though. This is a lot of, stuff on the screen for a Super Nintendo game as well. It's kind of impressive. Blue, why was a person not blue here? Can I talk to all these guys? Okay, they don't seem to do anything. There's a door here. Back to normal frame rates. Yeah, it was just balled down because of how much stuff was on the screen. I screamed because I didn't know what else to do. Okay. These are stairs. Yeah, it's another one of the statues. You look important. Are we going to fight you, though? Is the question. Okay. We're going to find out. Thanks for coming. I've been waiting for you. I need your assistance to help make the world blue and change it into a happy and peaceful society. Will you be my right-hand assistant?
Nope.
If you don't want to be my right-hand... my left would be just fine. Just kidding. Your existence is a problem for me and my religion. Defy me and I'll end your pitiful game. Oh, that's Carpainter. Okay. That makes sense with the lightning then. Carpainter's lightning was reflected by the Franklin badge. Oh, I guess I never needed to equip it then. Mini-boss? Boss? I don't know if this will work or not. Did it seriously just show a swastika on screen? Because that's kind of what it looked like, and that didn't work anyway, so it doesn't matter. Okay, so... We can do... You know what? Let's just go with Bash. Wow, that's a hell of a start. Good job. And he heals himself. He kind of just negated my smash attack. 33. Okay, we're okay. We're okay. Crashing boom bang attack. It didn't hit anyone. I assume that's his lightning attack, and... I mean, it's missed twice now, so maybe it just doesn't hit at all. Okay, psychic shield. I'm not gonna let my HP get too low, but we're not having much of a problem yet. Reflected the lightning. Oh, he just hurt himself. And he turned... That killed him. He killed himself. Good job. That's what you get for being a cultist. 1412. Please don't sue. Did you see the Mani Mani statue behind me? Since I got the statue, I've been doing peculiar things. Please forgive me if you can. I just wanted to have a normal life. I apologize to everyone. Here's the key to open a jail in the mountain cabin where Paula is being held. Take the key and go. Your backpack is full. We have a full inventory. You should take this even if you need to throw away one of your items. Okay, I think we can probably get rid of croissant. Or do we still need the Franklin? But you know what? We'll store the Franklin badge in case we should need it. Okay, give me key. Key to the. Is that all we need for Paula then, I guess? That was a bit easier than what I was. Like, I think I'm a bit over leveled too. That's kind of something I didn't want to let happen. Also, all these guys are gone. Looks like almost everyone woke up and left. There are only three people remaining. I don't want to stay. I'll get out of here. That's also a skip sandwich, so I don't need that. So, Rusty, if you're still here, you can tell me whatever you wanted to tell me now, because I'm pretty sure I'm pretty set on what I need to do now. What a horrible nightmare. I somehow woke up. Ness, let's be friends again. Please answer me. I promise to be good. Okay? Okay, Pokey. You're still a prick, though. Haha, I lied. See you. Yeah, you're a fucking twat. Okay. Since I don't know if anything's gonna happen with Paula, let's heal up to be safe first. I can't imagine. I think that was our Paula boss fight before we get her back, but we'll see. I don't even know if I have money on me. You're welcome to stay free of charge. Okay. It works for me. Okay, give me one second here. Okay, we're good. I suppose we should save, too. I don't think we saved for a while. Where's our telephone should be in the drugstore. You know what? I don't think we need to save. Cal, you're still blue, though. The blue Cal thing wasn't such a great idea after all. Well, actually, the whole town's still blue. Music's different, though. That's nice. Where's that cave at? There's that one. Here's the drug. You know what? We'll go ahead. It's right here. Oh, I have the hiccups. Also, I'm pretty sure my coffee's cold by now. I've been streaming for an hour and I haven't even started drinking yet. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. That's cold. I should have a decent amount of money. Yep, 1893. Excellent. Nessa's XP needed. 911. Okay. Right. No, the stream should be doing YouTube and Twitch only. I don't know why it would be streaming the Hitbox. Hold on. I mean, Hitbox shouldn't be streaming at all. Let me check out Restream real quick. No, Hitbox is turned off. 5 viewers on Twitch, 8 on YouTube, so... Yeah, I don't know, man. Alright. Alrighty, anyway. Alright, let's check out Paula. Sorry, just technical stuff going on there for a second. Okie dokie, so... I'm hoping... Did we, Yeah, okay, our PP went back up. That's good. I really need to watch my wording on some of those when I talk about the PP. Okay. Maturity, everyone. These crows should fuck off. Right? I mean, they're like level 1. No, I triggered 2 of them. Okay, please don't steal my cookies. I don't have any cookies, but if I did, I'm sure you would steal them. Yeah, concerning that debate against whether the bat is more accurate than the, slingshot, that's not even a debate at all. I don't think I missed one time since I switched to the bat. Whereas I was missing 2 or 3 out of 4 times when using the slingshot. I mean, someone told me not to use the yo-yo. So I'm assuming the bats are the go-to weapon for Ness. Yes, leave the cookie. I don't care about the cookie. Okay. Paula, you should be saved now. Ness, you got the key. Are you hurt?
Nope.
I'm sorry for all the trouble I've caused you. Yes? Do I need the use key? Ness, you... Oh, yeah, I just need to use it. Okay. Thank you, Ness. You're just like I imagined you would be. I'm sure that some people in Tucson are worried about me. Getting back there may be dangerous, but we can do it if we combine our strength. I'm able to use a little psychic power that is actually pretty deadly. Let's head back to Tucson. But I want to check out that other cave. I think we finally got Paula. You know what I'm most happy about getting a second party member? Is the inventory space. Look at all that. Look at all that space. She's also got a teddy bear. I mean, holy sh- yeah. Whoa, Paula, your stats. What's going on here? You're level 1. You, girl, you are gonna get wrecked. Causes a very cold wind to swirl around one enemy, inflicting about 180. Wow! May freeze the enemy completely. May not be so effective against some enemies. That's her only spell. That's a pretty damn good one, too, but... I'm pretty sure if she gets hit by absolutely anything, she's going to die. And I really don't want to grind on crows back here, so... That's so rusty. Oh, hey, man. What's up? YouTube chat might be a little bit glitchy for me. Sometimes I get every message and sometimes I don't, just a heads up. Because I'm trying, I consolidate my Twitch and YouTube chat into one box, and sometimes YouTube chat just gets left out for some reason. Also, oh wait, I saw something with Paula. I gotta get, hold on. There was an option there I didn't recognize. I don't want the cookie, by the way. But on YouTube, you should have a much less of a delay. Okay, let's see. Okie doke. Let's check your equipment here. Nothing. Okay. So, I'm assuming we're going to have to spend some money on you. Oh yeah. Okay, there is a frying pan for sale, so I assume that's for Paula. I was going to say earlier you can do that cave solo if you wanted, but better to get blood cave. Oh, you mean the, okay. Yeah, that's fine. I wasn't sure if, like, I don't even know if I'm supposed to do it now, honestly. She said go back to Tucson, but I kind of want to at least check out the cave. Yes. And then, I mean, if I mess it up, whatever. Maybe there's more, like, you can do more. Let me rephrase that. Maybe I don't have to do one or the other. Maybe I can do them both in any order. Also, Holmes hat and ribbon are both upgrades for Paula. I'm going to assume I want to buy the more expensive one. Also, I don't have enough for copper bracelet. I'm going to have to take some money out. 2 to 22. Yeah, let me see if I made a boo-boo here. Ooh. Sneaky there. Okay, I'm glad I didn't buy the Holmes hat. Because it is a... It's definitely, why am I blanking out? It's definitely a lesser item. I was going to call it a D-grade, but that's kind of... That's weird. Okay, anyway... how much money do I have? I need to 349. We will take out $300. That's plenty. We'll give a little bit left over. And we'll buy Paula a copper bracelet. Okay, and she's pretty pimped out now. She's going to have an empty slot for now, just because I don't have anything to give her. Yeah, her body's going to be empty for now. If I would have kept the travel charm... I could have gave it to her. I didn't even think about it. That's kind of... I mean, that's a mistake on my end, though. So it kind of made sense you would get a second travel charm. One for Paula. I didn't even think about it. So, that's a boo-boo. That's okay. Okay, so that's good. Okay, my concern here is, though, Paula's still level 1. Is she going to get completely wrecked if I go in here? Well, you know, she has a teddy bear, so hopefully the teddy bear will take most of the damage for her and give me a couple battles to get her leveled up. I mean, she needs like 20 experience points to get to level 2. This thing alone is probably going to get her to like level 4 or 5. So, we'll see how things play out. Oh, prey. I have no idea what prey does. Oh, thank you for killing the teddy bear instead of Paula. Chase the enemy... Paula just, I was reading the chat and I missed what Prey did, but Prey killed that mole and I'm not sure how. I'm gonna have to use it again. Paula got 228, okay. Yeah, she got level up fast. Sci-fire. Oh yeah, okay, level 5. Yeah, it's kind of odd they started her at level 1, but that's okay. They gave her a teddy bear, I guess, to kind of mitigate the problems that would come along with it. Also, I need to figure out what prey does. Psy fire. Fire bursts from the fingers in a row of enemies, takes about 80. Okay, not as good as Psy freeze, I guess. Well, that's not true because Psy fire damages the whole row of enemies, whereas Psy freeze just damages one. Okay. Well, we'll see how things play out here. Okay, we're gonna pray again. Oh, you killed my teddy bear. That didn't last as long as I wanted it to. Very subtle light engulfed Ness and Paul. Paula. Paul! Not Paula, Paul. Okay, so it healed that time. I'm pretty sure last time it killed the mole, though. I'm not sure. I want to get Paula a little bit more higher leveled before I start experimenting. I don't want her to die and I have to go revive her. Offense by 2. Yeah. Psy shield. Okay, she got shield. I want her to get a healing spell, though. It seems like the amount of HP or the PP she has at just like level 7 is kind of high, so I imagine when she gets to Ness's level, she's going to have a pretty decent amount of PP, probably much more than he has. Which means she might be our main mage user, magic user, Psy user. Can we? No problems here! Just a human skull on the ground. Yeah, we're gonna nope the fuck out of that, and we'll come back to that later, because there's like fucking. Yeah, there's a. Get out of here, mole! I'll finish that thought in a second. Actually, I shouldn't be telling to get out of here. Oh, he only did 11 damage to Paula. Okay. Yeah, her physical attack isn't very nice. She only did 8 damage there. Level 7. Yeah, she's getting like 5 PP per level. And now all those enemies are gone. Hello? Are you a bear? You're walking on your hind legs, so you can't be a bear. But you look like a bear. You look dangerous, too. Okay, we're gonna stick with moles for right now. Singular moles. Until she stops getting a level per battle. Yeah, he starts feeling strange, but I'm not really sure what that does. Well, he's doing more damage to Ness than what he did to Paula. It's a little odd. Ness leveled up. Offense by 3, defense by 2, speed by 1, guts by 2, vitality by 2, luck by 2. 25. Realize the power of life up? We already have life up. Maybe that's like. I don't know. We're gonna figure that out. That was a really good level up, though. I don't think we got any PP, however. Oh, I see. Okay. I guess that's a B. I mean, that looks like an A, a B. They look very Greek letterish, but I don't recognize that as a Greek letter, so I'm not really sure what that is. Restores 300 per person. Okay. Let's check this out. We got bats. Yeah, there's one, two, three. Yeah, there's about a million enemies there. Let's try to get rid of them. Yep, and they're gone. Not that I have anything against bats, I just don't. Great charm. Okay, I think we have a body item for her. Let's see what it does. Great charm! Must be equipped on your body. It protects you from paralysis. It also adds a bit of speed. Okay, so it's better than travel charm, so. You know what, Paula? As much as I'd like to give Nesta. What'd I just do there? I don't know what I just did there. Oh, I mixed up my B and A button again, like I did at the end of the game. As much as I'd like to give Ness the advantage, you are the lower level, so you do have the better charm. Bats are a joke. Okay, we will fight them then when we see them. Okay, there's a mole. Take him out. Well, we don't have to worry about giving Paula a body item anymore. I think I'm probably pretty good to try using Prey again to figure out what it does. Because I'm pretty sure the first time I used it, it killed the enemy, and the second time it healed me. Offense by 4, defense by 1, speed by 2, luck by 2, PP by... okay. Psy Thunder. Let's see what that does. Getting a lot of offensive spells with her, which making me think I probably want to focus on using Psy with her in serious battles. Let's see. To one enemy. The enemy is Thunderstruck for about 120 points. You may miss when there are few enemies. Eliminates a psychic or... okay, so it's basically a shield breaker. Not sure what the second line means. You may miss when there are few enemies. So is it more accurate the more enemies there are? Is that what I'm getting? It's kind of what it sounds like. What is this music in this place too? Oh, damn. I forgot to pray again, but it doesn't matter. That was an easy win. Hard to hit solo enemies. Okay. Makes sense. I don't know if this is progress or not. Yes, it is. Okay, I need to backtrack and get that present. Oh, there's bats. Here's a good chance to check out Prey, then. Okay, so Mr. Batty. Prey. Oh, yeah, that was a good idea. What I don't even know what I just did to myself. So, it looks like he just does random shit. Okay, so Prey equals do random shit. Could be good, could be bad. I don't even know what the status effect is, honestly. And I'm back to normal now. And she just attacked Ness. Okay, so that's like confusion. And she just attacked herself. Okay, let's get this battle done with. Okay, so I'm guessing Prey isn't very good. I was thinking maybe it was like a desperation type thing. Like, if you don't have any PP at all and you need to heal just a little bit, that would be a good thing to use. But if it just does random shit, I'll probably never use it again. I might check on the wiki to learn more what it does later. Also, we're probably about ready to be healed here. I don't have any healing spells that heals everyone. So we'll start with Ness. Paula, I don't even know what your max HP is now. It's probably still pretty low. Yeah, you're not even half. Alright, she seems to have decent defense, though. She seems to take less damage than Ness. I probably... also, I've been paralyzed. I probably want to be conservative with my PP, because I can't imagine I'm going to find many butterflies in this area since we're inside. That's just a guess. I don't know if that's, mechanic. Whoa! Okay, bat. That was cool. Don't kill Paula. Don't kill Paula. I think it attacked itself. Okay, good, Paula. Bye-bye. That was cool. Well, we made it pretty far without her going down. I'm actually surprised, considering what level she is. Maybe it'd behoove me to buy another teddy bear if they sell one at the drugstore, but now I need to get out of here and get her revived. Oh, she's a little ghost. I revive her at a hospital, I believe? That's kind of shit. Rip. So I'm going to have to talk to the doctor back in town. Also, everything's red now. That was my fault, because I thought, like, right before that battle, I thought about healing her, and I thought myself, nah, I don't need to, but I was wrong. And I paid for it. She doesn't get experience points either, naturally, so I don't really need to be killing these. Thank you. Oh, don't kill Ness, too. That would be no good. She's still got PP, though. Can she still use magic? That'd be something very weird. I guess she doesn't have anything she can use outside of battle, either. Okay. Ah! I was hoping I could outrun him. Okay. Well, I'd say the cave went okay considering Paula was such a low level. Let's get a revive though. I believe this is the kind of hospital for this place. Also, all the buildings aren't blue anymore. They were blue right before I went in that cave, I believe. Alright, doctor. Paula. I mean, she's not really sick, she's dead. Can you fix dead? A 110? Really? I figure it costs money, but that's a lot of money to revive somebody. Okay. Okay then. I don't have enough money on me, but whatever. Drugstore. Wow. Okay, so it'd be very who of me not to die like that, ever. Imagine when you have all four party members and they go- Well, I guess you, by that point you'll probably be making more money in the game. Also, here we go. 2,000 of a draw. Let's do 100. Okay, need a quick potty break. I will be right back. Alright, I'm back. It took her a bit longer, my dog wanted out. Alright, so revive Paula. I wonder if I'm gonna have to heal up after this too. I wonder if they'll put her back to full health. We're about to find out. Okay, so we talked to her. No. No! There we go. Okay, it looks like it healed her. Yeah, okay, they put it back to full health. That's good. I'd be a bit muffed if I had to, like, you know, revive her at the hospital, then heal at the hotel. But this is okay. Alright, back to it. Oh yeah, I wanted to check to see if they, drugstore has sold teddy bears. Well, you know what? It's probably not even worth the money, because that teddy bear only survived 2 battles, so, you know what? Fuck it. We'll just go for it and hope for the best. We just won't let Paula get low on health. Also, I don't really know how involved this place is. Because if it's super involved, then I'm, might have to do some grinding to get her ready for whatever's coming up. Because if this is actually a sanctuary location, there's probably going to be a pretty hard boss fight that she might have problems surviving. I was wondering if that bat could fly over that ledge, but he can't. So I'm having the hiccups again. Okay, we're doing better. We're doing better. Paula's the best. Yeah, just got her. I'm thinking with her, I should probably be using my offensive magic. She does have pretty high PP for only being level 9. She's already halfway to where Ness is, so we'll see, though. We'll get her a couple more levels. I really want her to get a healing spell. I'd be so happy if she was able to heal. Then I wouldn't have to worry about wasting so much PP with Ness healing. Also, I'm not sure how much damage she takes. I didn't think it was much, but then she got one hit KO'd by something. I think it was a mole out of nowhere. Level 10. Yep, 5 more PP. Her HP is going to be pretty fucking low from the looks of it. Also, I forgot about this present last time. Croissant. Okay, good. Okay, so this. Okay, you know what? I shouldn't be avoiding enemies since she's such a low level. Yeah, I kind of see Paula's becoming a glass cannon. Like, she's going to be able to dish out some massive damage with her magic, but then it's probably going to get destroyed anytime she gets attacked. So we're just going to have to play the rolling damage game with her, I guess. Also, Ness should be pretty close to a level up, I think. Yeah, he is. Oh, they both are. Okay, cool. 2 or 3 more battles and they both should be leveled up again. Also, there was... It probably despawned by now, but there was a bear up ahead. Oh no, he's still there. For some reason, I'm thinking he's going to be a bad news bear. I'm going to heal up against my better judgment here of wasting PP. But I have a feeling he's going to be an asshole. So, let's find out. Mighty Bear. Yeah, okay, so he's going to be a prick. Well, let's see what he's got. We're not too far in the cave, so if we die, it's not going to be nice, but it won't be the end of the world. Okay, bye, Paula. Oh, no, she survived somehow. Okay, Ness, be faster. Okay, good. Can we leave Paula alone? Jesus. Okay, let's try some magic here. Which one's the strongest? I think it was freeze, right? Because it only attacks one enemy. So that should do the most, you know, savage damage here. 149. Oh, and it froze. Okay, excellent, excellent, excellent. And it didn't stay frozen for very long, so there's that. I was expecting that thing to have massive amounts of HP, but evidently it didn't. It just hits pretty hard. Okay, freeze. Yep, okay. Freeze is best for singular enemies. Fire is best for rows of enemies. And then I'm still confused about thunder. I guess it... I don't know. I read it and I forgot what it does already. Okay, so, Mole, I want you by yourself. I don't want to trigger the bear. Also, butterfly. I might be able to despawn the bear. Yeah, there we go. And we kept the butterfly. I don't mind fighting the bear, but I'd rather just fight it on its own until we get more health on Paula. Croissant. Okay, I'll take it. Butterfly, still be there? Yes. Now, one would presume this heals both Paula and Ness. Or, not doesn't heal them, but increases their PP. So, good. Yep. Okay. Excellent. Ooh, two bears. Don't think we're ready for two bears. Also, since we have a freebie here. Yeah, okay, he was already fully healed. Oh, well. I probably want to go I'm going to go down there, whether I need to or not, because I don't want to... Well, I have to. I thought there was an area off to the left I could explore, but... No. Oh, wow, there's one, two, three, about a billion enemies there, so let's get rid of a couple of them. We also got the one up on the, Oh, insta-kills on the bats! Okay, and Paula leveled up. Was not expecting that already. Also, we got an upgraded Psy Freeze, which is nice. I really don't need that butterfly, so we'll just let him live his life. Here we go. So we have Freeze level 2 now. I should have probably read... Ooh, wow. That PP cost. As long as Ness hits, I should be able to hit with normal Freeze. Do me a favor and freeze him. Yeah, okay. There we go. Okay, we're okay. Damn, Paula. You're carrying Ness. And you're 10 levels below him. That was a shitty level up for Ness, by the way. I want to see how much damage... Let's see if I can menu right. I want to see how much damage the second level of freeze does. That does about 180, 360. Okay. So, pretty hefty damage. Okay. Can we get only the bat? We cannot. Oh, we got only the mole, though. Insta-kill? No. Nah. Well, if the bat's still there after we kill Mr. Mole here, that's free XP. So I can trigger him without pulling the bear down, obviously. Oh, shit. That was pretty good. Did I get it? Yeah, I got it. Okay. I thought he was going to get the jump on me because I turned my back at the last second. Oh, wow. Okay. Can we get just the bear? No, the mole is pulling forward, too. That's okay. Let's give it a try. We'll do, We got this. How many moles are there? Only one. Okay, so let's try Psy Slime, and then with you, we'll do Fire. Might be a bad idea, but we're gonna give it a try. Oh wow, that noise! Okay, we got rid of the mole, that's okay. Okay, we're good. As long as he attacks Ness, we'll be okay. This should be some pretty decent XP. Yeah, 533. Wow, PP by 9. Damn. We're going to be getting close to probably insta-killing these moles before too long. Also, Paula got attacked at some point. I missed that. Okay, I think we're making some decent progress here. Bats are there. Let's see if there's a present or something over here. Nope, they go in the same place, so... This looks like a little bit of a shortcut, so we're going to check out the long path to make sure we don't miss anything. We got moles. Is he going to pull the bear? Nope, just two moles. Now we can, actually want one of these to attack Paula, because I want to see how much damage she's taking. I don't know what Absent-Minded did, but... yeah, I don't think he's gonna do anything. Nope. That's a shame. The reason I want the mold to attack Paula is she hasn't taken any damage that I've noticed for quite a while. I know she took some damage somewhere, but I missed it. So I want to see how much a basic attack does against her. So I can kind of judge how much HP I need to keep her at safely. Okay, so we're going to bash you. You know what? Let's do it. Oh wow, okay, that was a bit overkill. I don't know what I was expecting. I knew it did about 380 damage. It only did two, it did less, it did 280 there, which is kind of weird. Also, I Psy Caramel. Okay, so if we get the caramel, let's see how much it recovers Psy. Can we menu correctly? Thank you. Let's see how much it recovers. 20, okay. I probably still want to be using Psy Freeze here. It looks like it freezes every single time, which is kind of nice. Because I've used it three, or like, what, four or five times now, and it's frozen the bear every single time. HP by two, that was kind of a shitty level up. Oh, we got boss. Okay. I'm not gonna lie, I don't think we're ready for this, but... I want to keep my PP. Also, for some odd reason, I have a cookie, so let's go ahead and use that. I'm nervous, honestly. I don't think this is going to go too well. I have a side caramel, so that's good. I can always pull that out in desperation. Alright, well, I know nothing about this boss at all, so... we'll see what happens. If there's a special thing I need to do, it's probably going to take me a little bit to figure out. You finally got here. This is the second your sanctuary. Oh, it is a sanctuary location. Okay. But it's mine now. Take it from me if you dare. Are you going to be an oversized ant? You are not. You are an oversized mole. Okay. So, we're going to shield. Remember your Psy abilities. Yeah. So we're gonna go ahead and shield Paula so she doesn't die. No! God damn it! Really? Yeah, I think like I said, I think I was still under leveled with Paula. I should have fucking grinded more, but that was, I mean, there was nothing I could do. No matter what I did, I wasn't going to survive that. He went first and attacked Paula right away, so there was just no way. I guess maybe if I would have planned to heal her first, I could have beat the rolling damage, but I mean, there was no way I would know how to do that, so. I guess we'll try to put it to sleep. Yeah, I didn't think it would work. Yeah, I'm going to lose this battle. Okay, well. Also, I misclicked defense again. I don't think I'm going to... well, he is faster than the mole. That's good. Okay, his shield's gone. I mean, I'm going to give it a try, but I don't think this is going to happen. We need a couple hits. I mean, I don't even know if I want it to happen. I'd kind of like to have Paula to have some of this XP. Oops. Hold on, I'm having controller issues here. It's like... I know, I'm having controller issues, that's my excuse, but no, when I'm pressing down, it's sometimes going to the left. It makes it hard when I'm trying to do stuff quickly, like if I'm trying to beat rolling damage. Also, I can't use any offensive spells, I'm almost out of PP. And I doubt I want to use my Psy Caramel. Because it's going to be gone if I have to do this fight. I'd want Paul. Should I throw? All right, I'll wait for the reply. Should I throw this battle then? And come back? There's a trick to this boss, though. I mean, I don't know in any situation where Paula could survive that first attack unless I had her a higher level. Well, I mean, like, I don't mind grinding. Like, I mean, I said right before the battle, I don't think I'm ready for this, which means I need to grind more. So that's not the issue. I'm wondering, though, if I missed something to keep Paula alive at the beginning of this battle, because if he attacks her every turn, it doesn't matter. I mean, I could probably get 5 more levels and she won't survive if he's doing over 100 damage, because she's got low HP. That's why I tried to put shield on her right away, but he went first, so it didn't work. But yeah, if this guy's gonna give me like 3,000 XP or something, I think I'd probably be better off just throwing this battle and coming back with Paula. You know what? I'm gonna throw it. It doesn't matter. I'll come back with Paula. I'll just take the loss in money. There's no point in me wasting all my items if he's gonna fucking... Yeah, I'll come back with Paula. I'll get her another level or two and we'll come back and try again. Because if he's gonna give a shit ton of XP, I don't want to win this battle without her. Well, I actually need him to attack, though. There we go. Okay. Ness is dead, I believe. Yeah, he's dead. It's that mortal damage. Okay. Now, I guess my question is, how am I still alive right now if I have 0 HP? Is it just waiting for me to make a turn? Okay, yeah, it is. That's kind of weird. Okay. Yes. Alright, so I lost whatever money I had on me, which luckily wasn't very much, and now I'm gonna have to pay to revive Paula, most likely, right? Yeah, okay, so I still need to revive Paula, then I'm gonna have to go to the hotel because I believe my PP is all gone. Yeah, it is. How much money do I have? Oh, it didn't take all my money. Does it only take half then? Or maybe it takes like 3/4. God, that I had over 100. Okay, I'm gonna need quite a bit of money here, so... 110 to revive Paula, then... Oh no, because the guy is healing me for free now, so... I just need 100. Did I get the money? No, I canceled it. So, like, here's a question. I wonder if I bought a teddy bear... You know what? The problem is getting the teddy bear to the boss, though, without losing it. Like, if I could buy a teddy bear and not deploy it until I got to the boss, that would be nice. You know what? The teddy bear idea was good in theory, but I don't think it's going to play out. Because I don't think I can get the teddy bear to the boss alive. And I'm assuming they actually sell teddy bears here. I'm not sure if they do or not. Yeah, okay, so they don't even sell teddy bears. Oh, well. We'll get Paula another level or two, and we'll try it again. Basically, I'm going to do the same thing I did last time. I'm going to try to throw shield on Paula right away and hope it plays out better. Maybe... No, you can't buy one here. Good old chat delay. But any, it doesn't matter. I would never be able to get to the boss alive anyway. Okay, Paula's alive. I mean, Ness wasn't having much of a problem with the boss, honestly. Because the most damage... As long as I keep him over 100 HP, he should survive unless it smash attacks me. Also, I forget where the hotel is. I think it's down here. Also, Cal's not blue anymore. Yeah, here we go. Yeah, I'm just going to chalk that battle up to being underleveled and bad luck. It was kind of like a lose-lose situation for me. Okay, everybody should be good. Let's take a look at our items here. We got a bread roll, the side caramel I can't buy, but I'm gonna keep that on me in case I should need it. Croissant, bread roll. Okay, so we're not short on healing items. Yeah, we're just gonna hope for better luck next time. Combined with slightly higher level Paula. So, also, the mole went before Ness. So, if I can get Ness's speed up, I might be able to get shield out before the mole attacks. Nice voice tweak, by the way. One way to do that is to take the charm I gave Paula and give it to Ness, and then just give Paula the travel charm. So Ness will get a little bit of check your psi moves. Okay. What, am I gonna have something that's like super effective against moles? Slime, it just does damage. Psy Flash, I guess, perhaps. The problem is with a boss, I don't know which, like, I have no idea what status effects it's going to be susceptible to, so I don't know if I should try to, like, paralyze it or use anything else. Like, I understand you're giving me a hint, but I'm not getting it, because I'm not sure, like, may not be so offended, may freeze. Like, to me, what you're saying is use Psy Freeze and maybe it'll freeze the enemy, maybe it's immune to, like, I don't know what it's immune to, that's the problem. Like, I don't have anything that tells me, like, hey, this is super effective against moles or something. So, yeah, I get it. I'm missing something pretty obvious, I'm sure, but I'm not seeing it right now. So maybe I'll figure it out. Also, let me check something real quick. 2,000, 1,000. Yeah, she's getting pretty high up there on XP needed to level up, so I don't know how much I'm gonna want to grind her. The problem is, like, that mole can hit up to 100 on Ness, which means he's probably gonna hit more on Paula because, yeah, his defense is even higher than hers. So, I mean, I can get her another fucking 4 or 5 levels, and her HP is never gonna be high enough to survive that, so I'm missing something very obvious. I'm gonna want to shield her. You know what? I'll wing it. I know I'm probably gonna want to keep her shielded. So how this is gonna play out is, if Paula goes down again, I'm just gonna try to win the battle with Ness, and then later on when I'm not streaming, I'll grind on my own and get Paula up to a suitable level. I don't want to miss out on this XP, but I also don't want to spend mass amounts of time grinding on camera and attempting this boss over and over again just to get her XP. That's assuming Ness can beat him on his own. I don't even know if that's a thing. How much is Psy Freeze? Oh yeah, I can use that a couple times before the boss, I'll be okay. Oh, it didn't freeze him that time. Okay, that's the first time it didn't freeze it. Also, there's one more thing I want to check. I want to check speed of Ness versus Paula. Paula is faster, okay. So maybe I'll have Paula cast shield on herself. That could work out. Also, that's a shitty situation right there. Right, I did try hypnosis. So that leaves paralysis and then that flash attack Ness has. Which I've read it like 6 times, I can't remember what the hell it does. I'm a little bit flustered with what happened, so maybe I'm not. Let me just ingrain this into my memory right now for the final time. So I know what paralysis does. That's pretty okay. So start trying. Crying uncontrollably. I don't know what that does. I made some fucking crows do it or some shit, but I don't know what it did. And also, I don't know what Feel Strange does. I assume that's like, oh, crying uncontrollably. You told me that it lowers accuracy. But the Feel Strange thing, I don't know what does. And this also doesn't damage. Okay, I'm gonna lead with paralysis, I guess. Also, can you guys fuck off there? Because I don't want to waste PP attacking all enemies at once if I don't have to. Yeah, I can deal with one bear though. Oh, fuck off, man. He did 25, she'll be able to survive another attack. Wow! That was lucky. Now the question is, can I get there without destroying this teddy bear? The RNG gods are looking out for me right now. What are the chances of that? Ah! No! Oh, hello. Okay. I mean, you say, I agree it's nice, but I don't think there's much of a chance of me getting there with the teddy bear intact. I mean, it might save me from using some PP and not taking as much damage. It would have been nice if I would have got it maybe in 5 minutes from now. Oh, wow, yeah, I can't get these bears to despawn either. I actually ended up spawning another one on accident. Ow! Oops. Well, evidently, if it touches the teddy bear... Oh, boy, that... No good. Oh, it actually attacked Paula. That's odd. Okay, that's good, though. As long as it doesn't attack, the teddy... Ah! God damn it! I'm being a spaz about this. I don't think I really need to, be this cautious. Right now, my main concern is trying to get the teddy bear as far as possible without losing it. Yeah, I don't think I'm getting rid of this bear. Let's just bite the bullet here. Okay, that's fine. You can attack Ness. Just leave Paul and the teddy bear alone. Okay, next battle should level Paula up. I think. It doesn't matter, I'm gonna get more. Can you guys fuck off with the bears? They haven't been bad at all this entire dungeon until now. Okay, I can take... Eh, whatever. I don't want to use too much of Paula's PP. I guess we'll be okay. I always hope for another butterfly somewhere along the way. Yeah, okay. So that teddy bear's got one more hit on it before it dies. The only reason I really wanted is to help survive that opening attack, so whatever. Also, that was a good level up. Okay, Ness, you don't need as much. Oh wow, I keep forgetting how much HP or PP that costs. 10. Okay, we'll be okay. That's 6. Oh, that mo. I forgot that's by row and not all enemies. That was silly what I just did. That was a waste. Because the mole's not on the same row. At least the bats are gone, I guess. Also, is Teddy Bear still alive? I wasn't really paying attention to the battle text. Yeah, he is. Okay. We're getting pretty close. If I can... Ah, bear! I wanted you to be on the top one. Go away. Yeah, there you go. Okay, butterfly. I need you more than ever. No, not gonna happen, are you? I don't know if I'm gonna be able to sneak past this bastard or not. Nope, okay. Well, we're at the boss. If Teddy Bear can survive this battle, we'll be set. So, I'm going to bash, I'm going to sigh, and I'm going to hope for the freeze here. Okay, we should be okay then. Okay, we're good. We made it to the boss with Teddy Bear intact, which I didn't think would happen. Ness, we're gonna get you fully healed. Let's just check my stats one last time. Speed 10, Paula's faster. Okay, I'm gonna open this battle with paralysis from Ness and shield on Paula from Paula. And if shit goes south from there, that's just because Paula's just too low of a level. I also have to hope he actually attacks the teddy bear and not Paula as well, so we're gonna go with paralysis. Hope it works. We're gonna go with shield on Paula and hope this plays out. Okay, yeah, that's good. Now, shield might not make... Also, that's definitely a swastika, I'm just saying. Also, paralysis worked, so... Thank you for telling me to try, look at my psi. I got what you were hinting at. I just wasn't sure if you were alluding to using paralysis or using psi flash. Also, I should be good to just, you know what? We're also going to use shield on Ness. And Paula, we're going to use your second level freeze. I don't think I can freeze him because he already Did that say 15 damage? No, that can't be right. I misread that. That's supposed to do like 300, unless it's immune to ice for some reason. Like, it's also still paralyzed, so... Okay, so that's... You know what, I'm almost positive it said it only did 16 damage, so... I mean, let's work on keeping Paula alive, I guess. My guess is it's immune to, like, freaking... Like, ice attacks, which is kind of weird for a mole. Wow, what the hell? Maybe I should try fire. Okay, I don't want Paula's shield to die out. Also, Teddy Bear's still alive somehow. I gotta remember that. Oh, the psychic shield. God damn it, I should have used thunder. Fuck. Also, that's nice. Paula, you are running out of... Oh, yeah. Alright. As much as I don't... Like, this is one of those items I consider too good to use, but I'm actually gonna use it. Because if I'm gonna beat this battle with Paul alive, it's gonna happen now. Also, that was nice as well. Okay, Paula, I don't want your shield dying, so you're gonna shield yourself again. Wow, I really overcomplicated that battle. Yep, about 3,000 HP, or XP. 22. Yeah. I got slime level 2. 15. Magnet. That drains PP. I do know that move. That was significantly easier than the first time I tried it. Also, we got a telephone call. Hello, it's your dad. You've been... Yeah, this is the official Nintendo you've been playing for too long. No, I don't want to take a break. So what happens if you hit yes there? Does it just, like, end the game? I'm sure it saves. That would be kind of a weird place for it to end, though. Also, tracks are right there. And I think that's our footprint we need. Ness briefly had a vision of a baby in a red cap. Ness's soundstone recorded the melody of Lilliput steps. Okay, cool. But yeah, that boss definitely might have just a little bit overestimated his power. He really wasn't that bad at all. Okay. So, there's no quick way to get back through this cave, so we're just gonna barrel through it. Honestly, guys, I'm probably gonna kill enemies on the way back because Paula is still a little bit lower level than S. Also, we got the advantage here. You know what? How much HP or PP does Paula have? Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting. We get fully healed after those sanctuary bosses, so. Yeah, we even get recover PP, so. And we got the opening attack here. And without the bear for some reason. Bye, Teddy. Oh no, Teddy Bear survived. Maybe Teddy Bear got healed too. Oh, Teddy Bear's dead. Pile of fluff. Rest in peace. Never forget. And if we're quick about this, we might be able. Ugh, that was a sentence. We might be able to get a surprise opening attack on Bear. Match some HP by 22. PP by. Okay, that was a really good level up. That's the best one we've had so far. That was kind of awkward. Somehow we got it, though. Okay, Paula's not too bad now. She can definitely hold her own. I say as she just gets completely destroyed. I really want her to learn a healing move, though. Right now, Ness is our only healer. Skip those ones. See if I can remember how to get out of here. Yeah, here we go. Also, I believe there's two bears here. And that's a lot of XP. And we got the opening attack, so we're gonna give it a try. Nope, just one bear. We'll attack bear first. And I really don't need to be too conservative with my PP since we're on our way out. Alright, dead. Stay out of here. Mole is running. I believe that means I can insta-kill him now. Hopefully. Also, I definitely hit him in the back there. No, it most definitely does not mean I can insta-kill. I just saw him running and assumed. Bats, I really don't care about you. Yeah, okay, we're pretty over-leveled here, so let's just get out. I believe it's up this way. Question is, what do we do now? Oh wait, I already know what to do. Paula said we need to go back to Tucson. Okay. Let's go up here. How much money we have. I deposited $2,279 in your bank account. Taking what you spent, you now have 3,000. Wow. Okay, lots. We have lots. Alright. Good enough. Alright, guys. That's it for me today. I'll be streaming tomorrow. Probably. Well, I know. I'm going to be streaming this. I'm saying I've been trying to stream Final Fantasy VIII more all week, but I'm having too much fun with this. So, I'll be streaming more Earthbound tomorrow. Thanks for everybody who tuned in. Next time we'll be going to Tucson and doing various things. After that, I don't know where we're going. I assume Threed. That's the only other town that's been even mentioned in the game so far. But yep, that's it. Thanks for everybody who's watching, and I will see you tomorrow.